Hello, my name is Michael Owzareck. I'm from the German company block Transformatoren-Elektronik GmbH. Welcome to my poster presentation with the topic Metrological Law Separation to determine the influence of power electronic currents on static hysteresis losses of passive magnetic components. First, I'd like to start with the motivation of my work. In the future, passive magnetic components like chokes in converter systems will operate at higher switching frequencies. This is because of the use of SiC and GaN semiconductors and the resulting higher switching frequency. This affects the magnetizing current and indirectly influences the core losses. So the target of my work is to investigate the hysteresis losses increased because of the magnetizing current under power electronic application. That's the first thing, is to build up a measurement system which can subdivide the losses into eddy current losses and hysteresis losses. And the second thing is to measure under power electronic conditions. First, we have to understand the principle of loss separation, and the core losses are the mean value of the instantaneous core losses multiplied with the volume of the core, and that's equal to the sum of the hysteresis losses, eddy current losses, and the microstructure eddy current losses which occurs to the displacement of bluff walls. These instantaneous core losses are also the sum of these three types of core losses. And they are a function about the speed of the magnetization or the change of flux density over time. In the literature, you find this equation 3 and 4 for the eddy current losses, and when you see here, they are also a function of the instantaneous core losses and the change of flux density. Insert this equation 3 and 4 into 2, you will see that the applied field is the sum of the static hysteresis field, the eddy current field, and the microstructure eddy current field. And this dynamic part here, a function of the speed of the magnetization. So when you bring the dB dt to zero, then it's possible to directly measure the hysteresis field because it's equal to the applied field. And so it's possible to measure under this condition, the dB dt goes to zero, directly the hysteresis losses. In state of the art, there are three methods to make this loss separation. There's a mathematical method where you measure the energy difference. You have the measured core losses or the core loss density, and you subtract the classical eddy current part on the sinusoidal conditions, and then you have it's equal to the hysteresis loss energy and the microstructure eddy current loss density. And when you plot it here in black over the square root of the frequency and extrapolate it to zero, then it's possible to calculate the hysteresis core loss density. This is a drawback because the eddy current parts here neglected the skin effect in the cross-section area of the core. The second part method is the quasi-static measurement. To bring the dBt at very low to zero is to measure under frequency perhaps 1 millihertz, or when you use a device under test and you use it in the transformer load no load condition, then you have noise on the secondary side because the signal you want to measure is very small, and this is a very difficult task. And then the method 3 is a static measurement under direct current, and it's the IEC standard to measure the hysteresis properties of soft magnetic components, and my work based on it. Here is my measurement set. I use a personal computer with a digital signal generator. It converted from digital to analog with a digital analog converter. I have an industrial amplifier. For magnetic device under test, I use a 25 centimeter Epstein frame. On the secondary side, I use a flux meter to measure the flux. And here I use for the applied field measurement a shunt to measure the magnetizing current. The most part is in the software, because I can enter the power electronic current into the software. Here, perhaps the current of a grid choke for a B6 rectifier, and I converted it into equivalent DC current, direct current, with the same maximum minima, because then the minor loops in the magnetizing loop are the same. Here you can see on the right side a typical magnetizing process where you have the demagnetization, and then you measure under this direct current condition. You see the speed is very low, and you can measure the hysteresis properties of the sample. And for the sample, I use a non-oriented electric steel M450A. Then I tested it on the sinusoidal condition first, and I measure under dynamic conditions. Here you see, with increasing the frequency, the areas of some dynamic hysteresis loops are increased, because the energy density is a function of dBdt, and you see an increase of the area and of the energy density. And when you measure with this setup for the static measurement, you can measure the static loop, and it's equal to zero, and this is hysteresis loss density. Then, when I have this sinusoidal boundary condition, I can compare it, and I measure under this condition here, which I explained before, and I measure with the B6 rectifying current, and I can compare it not always to the sinusoidal condition. And then you see, when I measure under this B6 rectifying current for a grid choke, I have here some minor loops here, and here also on the bottom, and the core loss density, hysteresis core loss density, will increase here from the black here to the blue a little bit, because there are not much liner loops. When you investigate other typical current waveforms, you will see that for a sine wave filter, when you have which is placed between the motor and the converter, you have sinusoidal current with a ripple on a 10% ripple, and for different switching frequency for 2, 4, 3, and 6, and 8, you will see there are much more minor loops. And the ripple have also influence here, and we can see when the ripple increase, the area of every single minor loop will increase, and when you increase switching frequency, the numbers of minor loop will increase, and for these conditions and for this application, the hysteresis energy loss density will increase. So my conclusion is, I investigate, I compared various methods for core loss separation, and I use a new technique where I use the IEC standard for direct current measurement and the static behavior of the soft magnetic material, and I converted the power electronic current into a DC current. And now it's possible to measure under this condition the hysteresis loss density. This data can be used in the future for improved the core loss models which are in use. Based on the measurement results, so you can see with increasing the switching frequency, the numbers of minor loop will increase, and with ripple, the area of every single minor loop will increase. Thank you for your attention. And I'm looking forward to further discussion at the virtual round table. Thank you very much.